Jason Lowe trifft auf die Nummer 7 der Setzliste, inzwischen die Nummer 23 der Welt. Hat in diesem Jahr seinen zweiten PDC-Titel gewinnen können, und zwar auf der European Tour bei den Austrian Darts Open in Graz. Ein Mann, der sich in den letzten anderthalb Jahren wirklich nach vorne gearbeitet hat in Richtung Weltspitze. Aus Wales, Johnny Clayton, the Parrot!
Well, one seeded player has been dumped out in the very first game of the tournament here on day two of European Darts Match Play, live from Hamburg, in front of a capacity crowd. The Welsh number two, Johnny Clayton, is hoping to avoid the fate of the Australian number one, Simon Whitlock. He goes up against Jason Lowe, though, whom we saw in the first round defy a 100 average from Keegan Brown to win it 6-5, and he didn't have to survive any match darts either. Keegan was going to come to the board with three match darts in the penultimate leg, but Jason Lowe just showed the nerves of steel that the builder from the West Midlands has displayed a number of occasions this year, both on the Challenge Tour and on the Pro Tour, and took out an 84 finish. And it could well prove to be a vital one, not only in the hopes of Jason Lowe this weekend, but in the hopes of a number of other players, because he has the game to beat everybody here. He is a very, very dangerous competitor. Paul Nicholson alongside me, Dan Dawson, for this second game. It's the Ferret versus J-Lo.
The flag, Johnny, to the first. Game on.
Yeah, I'd be interested to see how Jason performs today. Obviously, it was his debut yesterday on the European Tour, and he handled it very, very well. I'll tell you what, if I need any building work done on my house, he's the kind of guy you want to call, because he just doesn't look like he gets stressed by anything.
True, although whether he'll actually turn up, because he might be too busy playing top-class international darts all over the place, because he's going to get more opportunities with the way he's playing.
I did say a few months ago that if I wanted some plastering done, I'd call Johnny Clayton, but he's been playing too much darts as well.
Yeah, he has scaled back his work a bit, Johnny Clayton, just to try and focus on the darts.
100.
He did say when he won his first Pro Tour title, sort of September-ish last year, it was the last one of the year, that he put it down to hard work and dedication. I'm not sure I believe 60. Him, because the players I talk to say Johnny's a guy who just rocks up 5 minutes before the last cutoff, sits around having a chat, and then gets called to his board, he picks up his darts, 5 minutes, he's away. Oh, and he's thrown another 100 average.
I'm afraid that's correct. If you go to Pro Tour events, you know, I'm the kind of guy who turns up 3 hours before. I like to get settled in. Johnny usually turns up at about 10:45.
140.
He's top seed nowadays as well, so he's first on.
Yeah, he's only got about an hour to get ready for the first game. But some people are like that. I used to have a guy in my local team 20 years ago called Jimmy Yellerly. And he used to turn up about 3-4 minutes before the first game, and he threw brilliantly. Some players are like that, some people need a lot of time. Double 10 for Johnny Clayton. Two fives.
75.
And that's what you don't want to leave. Something tricky that can just get a bit sticky.
Yeah,
Jason Lowe not having his best leg though.
No, he has dominated this leg, Johnny Clayton, so he is going to get plenty of chances. But they are the sort of situations where you can give away legs, these. Well, that's an interesting decision.
Favourite double. Double one.
Score.
Not right now, it's not.
Well, at least you got two darts at it. The problem is if you go 3-1 and you miss inside, then you're only getting one dart.
Well, Jason looks a little bit more perspired today. It is quite hot in here. No shocks there, really. But will he go three again? I think he will. A double one. Same hole as the second dart last time. But this time he finds the adjustment and he gets the first leg. An Amiga 21 darts, but he won't care about that.
Yeah, well, Jason Lowe will just be telling himself that's a hold of throw, doesn't really matter.
100.
Well, if he was feeling any sort of stress in that first leg, he's not showed it. Showed nothing yesterday. And Keegan Brown, 86. As disappointed as he will be with losing, he can be happy with the way he performed, and he's going to go to Blackpool feeling good. I'm intrigued to see what we're going to get from Jason Lowe in the next 89. Couple of seasons, because it is very, very possible that we'll see him on the Pro Tour next year.
Certainly, and we mentioned yesterday about the Challenge Tour. I know Michael Barnard is streets ahead because he's winning more tournaments than anybody, but Jason Lowe is the highest on the average list, and that shows that if he just continues that, you'd think he's going to start picking up titles and maybe even challenging Barnard, who knows. Michael Barnard was here this weekend, but it was a strangely below par performance from Michael Barnard in going out of the tournament.
He got dorfed yesterday.
He did.
Langen dorfed.
He did, and we'll see if Gerwyn Price gets Langen dorfed in the next game on stage, because the winner of that one will play the winner of this one, and it could be an all-Welsh clash and a repeat of the European Tour final from Graz, the one that the Ferret went and won his first big stage title in PDC darts.
Nobody says Graz like Russ Bray.
Nobody does. 81. Nobody can.
Jason, you require 112.
Much better leg this from Jason Lowe.
It's a perfect first dart. He's got choices. Doesn't even contemplate the risky bust shot because he's hit the 112 and he is 1-1 with Johnny Clayton, the seventh seed. Got a bit of an observation as well, Dan. I was thinking about this yesterday and I saw Jason coming out the lift this morning and said, well played. Of course, he just said thank you and trundled off. He's got massive hands.
He's builder, isn't he?
Size of those mittens.
Yeah. Right. The claws of a JCB.
Just because his second name's Lowe, should we start calling him Lobo too? Because that's what Sid Waddell used to call John Lowe. Lobo. Same sort of mentality as well.
Well, I mean, yeah, the demeanour is pretty much identical.
Yeah, great throws. Didn't give much away.
And there is nothing wrong with that throw. It's, I know, like, Jason Lowe might come across as a sort of unassuming character. He certainly does in his interviews, or the few ones that we've had. You know, his on-stage demeanour. He looks like the guy you'd run into in a game of darts in the pub, but he throws world-class stuff. And when you look at that throw, there's not much wrong with it at all. I mean, nothing as far as I can see.
There's a lot of players like that out there. And I think because of the fact that the Pro Tour doesn't need entry fees anymore, then you'll find more of these guys starting to feed into the system. If they feel like they've still got a bit of game left, they will find their way to the Challenge Tour and potentially to the next level as well. I feel that was a huge thing that happened. It drew people from around the world, and especially around the UK, to try and have a go at the Challenge Tour and beyond.
Beautiful darts. Game wonderful stuff from the Ferret. 148 checkout. None of this messing about in a madhouse like in leg one.
Yeah, very good from Johnny Clayton. Former champion of champions winner, of course.
And that is essentially a pub tournament, isn't it? It's like the news of the world in pubs all over the country. Best of three legs. Gerwyn Price was a winner. Johnny Clayton was a winner.
Paul Hogan,
indeed,
defending champion. And that tournament is happening, I think, in a couple of months. Interesting to see who joins that role of honour.
Well, it could be a champion of champions versus a champion of champions is the next round. We'll find out who the champion of the champion of champions is. Sort of.
I think if it's Johnny Clayton versus Gerwyn Price, the winner gets to keep the jacket from Austria.
Well, you and I well know that's already in a frame. He'll have to take it down off the wall, Johnny Clayton.
He's had it framed, but it's in the cupboard.
Yeah, framed and in the cupboard. Yeah. I mean, presumably he's picked somewhere out, he's going to hang it. He's not frame it and just shove it in a box and not think about it.
Well, if he needs somewhere else to put it, he's the kind of guy who can put a wall up and plaster it.
That is true. 60. I did get told a stat yesterday. I think it may be dubious in that every European tour so far has been won by a person whose English is not their first language beating somebody whose English is their first language in the final. And my immediate question was, well, Johnny Clayton, obviously English is his first language. But I'm told that apparently Welsh might actually be his first language. Speaks it at home. You can see the names of his kids, Fionn and Clea, on the collar of his shirt.
Is that a 112 finish, Jason Lowe? He's not going to get the 120.
60.
He's been good Johnny finishing in the last couple of legs. Can Johnny Clayton raise the bar? He's over the bar on that one.
100.
Good layup though. It's a battle of the same two-dart shot. Who can convert it? Jason starts land quite flat. He's got plenty to aim at here. Nothing obstructing tops. And well executed. Stays with Johnny Clayton, and very much like yesterday, it's close against Keegan Brown it was, and it is with Johnny Clayton.
121.
It is, but it's perhaps not the standard we expect from these two. The thing is with the ferret, we know that when he really performs, he can do incredible things. He can go and average 110, because we've seen him do it on the tour this year. He did it against Kirk Shepherd, average 109. He did it in beating Van Gerwen with 111 average. And he can follow it up as well. The
100.
Pro Tour earlier on in the year when he did beat Van Gerwen and averaged 111. The rest of that day, he made it to the final, lost to Jeffrey Desvan. But he averaged 105, 101 and 100 in various other games through the day. We know he can do that. But overall, he's only just inside the top 32 in the averages list, because there's a lot of other games where he's in that sort of 90 range, maybe even high 80s. I think at the World Cup, I was a little bit disappointed with the Welsh team, because I don't think we saw the best from either of them in
not
the World
at all.
Cup.
Not at all.
I thought they were my dark horses to go and win it, and neither of them really had, like, even one game where they just went, this is what I'm about.
If they have solid seasons going into next year and they play together again, I think they'll be more threatening.
I think so. I think certainly with Johnny being his debut in the World Cup, and he talked about how nerve-wracking it was. You know, not just representing yourself, but your country, not wanting to let your teammate down. Here, it's all for the ferret. But the 96 doesn't go for the ferret. And this could be a turning point in the game.
A possible game changer. He needs 318s. He's only just over the top of that. That's a really good effort, you know. And he hits one with dart 3. Johnny can't miss this. Left or right? Double 10, one dart. He loves double 10, but not this time. And stressful, Johnny Clayton. You can see.
Jason
now has given himself the opportunity. And the way he's been picking these off this season. Oh, there you go, there's the proof. He's got to break a throw. And all of a sudden, a situation where Johnny should have been 3-2 in front on throw, he's now 3-2 behind. And he requires a break if he's going to get through this tie.
It might not be quite the explosively vast difference between the two players, but this does have shades of the Whitlock pipe game we've just seen, where one guy is outscoring the other one's just sort of plodding along in his slipstream, and then when he makes mistakes at the end of legs, he's there to tidy it up. Justin Pipe did that to perfection against Simon Whitlock, who hit 6 180s and only came away with 3 legs.
140.
Jason Lowe doesn't look like he's going to let go of his throw anytime soon. So Johnny Clayton is up against this. And a lot of those darts are going above that 60 bed. And I'm not sure that that's right for the way his darts fly. I think he's better when it goes in the bottom half or just below.
Is it a bit of a Terry Jenkins where you think he can go either side, but not perhaps. I mean, Terry didn't seem to mind. And again, you see there, he's gone over both of them, and he's not able to.
Hasn't been much switching going on in this game. It's been stubborn work on the 60. Jason Lowe has got six darts from 155.
60.
And you'd be disappointed with that. Because if Johnny Clayton manages to get a ton plus score here, he's not going to.
95.
That's the bare minimum.
Jason, you're requiring 95.
Where's he going to go?
Is that a ball first dart or not?
19s, I think. Right. Make a choice and stick with it.
47. Johnny McGuire, 146.
Two trebles. Would have left a double. But it is looking like we could see a two-leg gap open up here. And the number seven seed and winner on the European Tour already this year, Johnny the Ferret Clayton, is in a spot of bother here against the European Tour debutant Jason Lowe.
Can't give Johnny Clayton chances like that. Earlier in the match, he took a 148 where he got two treble 20s and double 14. One treble 20 and one double 14 this time. And he rescues the situation, a chance that he probably thought he wouldn't get. This game is back level.
Oh, Jason Lowe had only missed one dart at double before that leg. He missed two there. Something he had not been doing thus far in the game. And what may have been a turning point in the fifth leg has just been erased. Back on throw.
See, Jason Lowe's going half hanky here with the shirt.
Well, as the weekend goes on, and particularly tomorrow, if anybody makes a final day and is then playing potentially four games in the day, I mean, the zips won't go down far enough on the shirt.
Yeah, get the scissors out. Talking to a couple of lads yesterday,
100.
And I actually said to Mark Wilson, the only advice I can give you really is just drink loads of water, because
100.
The stress up there and obviously a little bit of anxiety and a bit of pressure, just having lots of water, it just keeps your brain fresh.
Mm-hmm. It is tough up there.
140.
Staying well hydrated in the crowd, or at least something along those lines.
German hops water.
14. Jason, you require 137.
Well, even the officials have been struggling at times up there. Speaking of a few of them, including our referee. Hugh What When Where, will he be calling game shot here? He won't be.
120.
But it's another great chance for a break, unless Johnny Clayton produces another moment of magic. The 148 went earlier.
I think he was in two minds there where to go. He looked at the 60, then he went straight down to the 19s before he threw it.
Jason, you require 16.
And Jason Lowe can't miss this time. A couple of misses last time out cost him. Not this time. Might be in the bottom corner. But he's got it. He's 4-3 up again, and he has the break of throw again.
Yeah, four holds of throw, followed by three breaks.
Earlier in the week, the hot weather started, didn't it? And I think the part of the UK that got the hottest weather was West Wales. Not far from where Johnny Clayton's from. I have to say, it's not a part of the country that I've spent a lot of time as. The furthest I've gone west in Wales is Llanelli.
Ah, yes.
Home of Scarlets.
That's a pretty good Welsh pronunciation you've got there.
It was really funny hearing my sat-nav trying to pronounce the streets. That was very entertaining.
Turn left at Llanelli. Yeah. Now then.
121.
Can Johnny Clayton make it? Four breaks of throw in a row.
Well, if he doesn't, he's got a real issue, because Jason Lowe, I know these guys are only averaging in the mid-80s, well, mid to high 80s right now, but Lowe just looks solid. It's not erratic or anything. He's not having a brilliant leg and a poor leg. It's just sort of plodding along at those six visit legs. That's pretty much what he's doing.
He does remind me of that kind of club or pub player that would always hit one treble against you.
Yeah.
And the occasional two. Just so hard to beat. And how's he going to get that 60? Nearly did. from a tricky angle.
Jason, you require 100%.
But this could be the game-changing shot. This could give him the two-leg cushion. He should get a dart at a double. That double is double 16. For 5-3. Only just wide as well.
Well, he is hitting 50% of his doubles. It's a coin toss whether he hits those doubles. Johnny Clayton is taking more darts to find the doubles, and that's a long way off for Clayton. It's 3 out of 13 on the outer ring for Johnny Clayton, and it's just not good enough against this standard of opposition. You've got to be scoring like an absolute demon to make that work for you.
Well, he threw that second dart rather fast for him. Oh, the third one's only just wide as well. Three really on the wire. Reprieve for Clayton. He gets away with it again. Is his luck going to be in to give him the opportunity for another shot at a title tomorrow? That's going to be the case. He needs two more legs. And he is in the box seat. He will have the throw in this leg and potentially the last one.
Well, the ferret might weasel his way out of this game, but if he does, he can count himself a little bit fortunate.
Do we have a dart player called the Weasel?
Not that I'm aware of as yet. We had on the European Tour earlier this year, the Sweet Ferret. Yeah, don't look at me like that, Nicholson. I've not made this up.
The Sweet Ferret.
The Sweet Ferret.
Who was that?
That's a very good question. I'm going to find out for you.
Is that like having a cobra and a black cobra?
It's...
We've run out of nicknames.
Johan Engström. Oh, yes. Johan Engström, the Sweet Ferret. I'm not making this up.
That's quite an embellishment on Johnny Clayton's already established nickname.
Yeah, look, it's...
30.
I don't know if anybody else can think of a better darts nickname than that.
Winner of the Finnish Open, 2012. There you go. 30. Had the Estonian Open the year before. And he made the Euro Tour for the first time this year. The Dutch Darts Masters in Zwolle. And he was beaten 6-2 by the Lethal Biscuit. Yeah, the Lethal Biscuit versus the Sweet Ferret.
Doesn't get any better than that.
Yeah. I mean, again, if you switch those around, it actually fits better. The Lethal Ferret and the Sweet Biscuit.
Well, we had the Lethal Chin and the Super Biscuit yesterday
in
the crowd.
Exactly. Anyway, Clayton has left himself 1-2-2. Lowe is going to leave himself something better.
137.
He is indeed. This is a big moment. Single 18. And a single 18, Johnny. A single 18. How many times have I got to tell these players, don't go for the treble, guarantee the ball. I'm going to be quiet now, because Jason Lowe is going to need 20 and double 16 for another break of throw.
Game shot the ninth leg, Jason Lowe.
Once more, we see Lowe edge in front. The ferret has not led since being pegged back to 2-2. There has never been more than a leg between them. But if that changes in this leg with a hold of throw for Jason Lowe, then it is a second seeded player going out of the tournament in the first two games of the second round.
How many times do situations like that cost you? Get the big number. I know that sounds a bit like what Rod Harrington says about don't miss the big number, but
do not miss the big number, as we call it. I mean, he doesn't say it for a lot. It's true. It's valuable, valuable advice.
Yeah, don't gamble on the treble.
100.
Go for the big 18, the big high chunk of it. If you somehow spawn the double, fantastic.
Well, I always think that when you've got 68 left for two darts, it's probably worth sticking it towards the double, because if it does accidentally go in, you can have a safe effort. It's a wider part of the number anyway. And if it does accidentally go into the double, it leaves you on double 16.
The thing is, a lot of players would come up to me and say, well, what happens if I go too high and I miss the board? Well, it's the same as hitting the four.
It is.
Because you're not getting a shot at a double.
And you can always have a safer effort at it, can't you?
Yeah.
Just give yourself a chance to win, then. It's much better to have a dart at the ball than nothing at all.
Is it going to be another 6-5 game involving Jason Lowe.
59.
It could well be.
Yesterday in the 11th leg, he put in a beautiful 80 finish to finish that match against Keegan Brown.
He did. Back-to-back finishes of 80 and 84 in the last two legs. Keegan was on a double in the penultimate leg, but he kind of messed things up in the decider. The ferret has bounced back, though. But when we've had break after break after break after break in this leg, you're not sure how much of an advantage it is throwing first in the last leg decider. Assuming we get that far, 90 needed.
Didn't go for 20s. Went for double-double, and I don't understand that either.
I mean, give yourself a leg, a dart for the leg. We've just been saying that in slightly different circumstances, but you're letting Jason Lowe have a go at this 1-2-4 again. He wasn't very far away.
Oh, and he's not very far away again, but he still doesn't get a dart.
56.
Oh, Johnny Clayton has to convert this still. Double 16 for 5-5. That is a good guide.
32.
Didn't use it, and Jason Lowe will have one dart for the match, surely.
He is hitting more than 40% of his doubles. He's only going to get one for the match here, though. Double 16, the target.
52. Johnny requires 16.
Can Johnny Clayton take us all the way this time? Yes, he can. It's 5-5, unbelievably. And the seventh seed has the dart, unbelievably. He is now the favourite for this game.
But the last six legs have all been breaks of throw. Can somebody find a 12 darter?
83.
I don't know where my money is.
I'm keeping it firmly in my pocket.
It's one of those 6-5 on games right now. Just don't know who's going to win this leg and this match.
Well, there you go. Nobody has managed to find a 12 darter. They have been rarer than a salad at a Hendo party. But if somebody could just kick in. We've only had one maximum in this game. One here could change it.
You're absolutely right, by the way. John's not into salad.
Nah, of course he is.
It's as rare as fruit at a Robert Thornton picnic.
Right, well, quite.
100.
He will not be pleased with those percentages. Jason Lowe will think that's a little below his best, but Johnny Clayton will be horrified by 28%.
He needs two trebles to get back level pegging. And he's got them, and now it's all about the setup shot. Who's got the better one?
Looks like Johnny Clayton's going to get there.
140.
And just when you think he's up against it, it's a bit like, you know, don't put baby in the corner. It's don't put a ferret in the corner.
Don't.
He's come up with the best leg of the match so far.
But that equals it, and he's got a better double. There's problems. Real problems. Massive problems, and the ferret just looks askance at the double 19. He is getting closer and closer and closer, but not close enough. And Jason Lowe for an enormous win. The Austrian Darts Open champion is knocked out. Jason Lowe holds his nerve, breaks the throw, and finds himself on his debut on the European Tour in the final day of action. There will be no All Welsh clash in the last 16 between Clayton and Price. Jason Lowe has a chance. He is one win away from a quarter final on his debut on the European Tour.
Bei seinem Debüt auf der European Tour zieht in das Achtelfinale ein, erreicht also den entscheidenden dritten Tag. Mal sehen, was er selbst dazu sagen wird. Jason, congratulations. I just said, I mean, that's your first time you're playing on stage on European Tour. You're not used to playing in front of such a crowd, but it's working out brilliant.
It's quite nerve-wracking, to be fair, yeah. Yesterday was my first time, so I don't think I've done too bad.
You reached twice the semi-final on Pro Tour this year. How important is that to behave like you do on stage?
Well, I made two semi-finals, so I know I can perform. It's just to me, it was whether I could do it on stage or not, and I think I can. I know that game was a bit scrappy, but you know, I can.
I don't know why I asked that. John Lowe, was that your big idol when you were younger?
Yeah, he might have the same name, but I was a fan of John Lowe's, yeah.
Okay, so cool. There's it to you tomorrow again. Congratulations. Jason Lowe.